Hello, my name is Keshwani.
It's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I,
Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the HESI. We have been working on our vocabulary lessons out of the words from this book, chapter 3 of this book. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. The HESI Admission Assessment Exam Review, the 3rd edition. In the event that you need help with the math portion of this exam, we have already solved all the math problems from this book. You will find the solutions to every single one of them in the series of HESI math series from day number 1 through 50. There are 50 tutorials. If you need more help, you will find 80 more videos on math from the TEAS exam. The math on the TEAS and the math on the HESI, as you know, are very comparable. Today we're going to talk about two pairs of words. That's it. Only two pairs of words. Let's get going. I want to understand the difference between distant and protrude. Do you know what the difference is between the notion of distant and notion of something protruding? Let's first take care of the pronunciation. Distant is very simple. Obviously, it's a verb. And protrude, which is also a verb. What does it mean to distant? Distant and protrude are two different concepts. To distant means to expand. To expand. Or to swell due to internal pressure. For example, one might talk about a distended balloon. A distended balloon is so called because the balloon is swelled, is expanded, because you put air in it and it causes the pressure inside the balloon and it causes it to expand. A distended balloon. What does it mean to protrude? Well, protrude is a different notion. Protrude simply means to stick out. To stick out. So if we have a picture here, right here, and here is the part, let's say this is the map of a country. Well, this area here is protruding, to stick out, to jut out, to project. Something is projecting. Project has several different meanings. If you use it in this context, that this part is projecting, that means it's protruding, it's jutting out, it's sticking out, it's protruding. Protrude and distend. Distend is to expand due to internal pressure, and it expands in a uniform way. The entire shape expands in a uniform way. There is not one part that's sticking out. And if that's the case, then the notion, the word that we use is protruding, not distending. Let's talk about another pair of words. And the words are very simple, very straightforward word. What's the difference between dysfunction and malfunction? Well, it turns out that there is no difference. Let's first take care of the pronunciation. Dysfunction and malfunction. They both mean to fail to function, to fail to work in a proper manner. To fail to function in a proper manner. To fail
to work, to fail to function in a proper manner. To function or to work abnormally or imperfectly, or imperfectly. We need an adverb to function or work imperfectly or abnormally, or to fail to work in a proper manner. So the question still lies, when do we use the word dysfunction and when do we use malfunction? It's a tricky one. From what I understand, and I may or may not be right, but from what I understand, the term malfunction is to be used in the context of machinery. One hears of a dysfunctional family. A dysfunctional family, one does not hear of a malfunctioning family. From what I understand, as I said, malfunction, the term malfunction is used in the context of machinery. Machineries, when a given piece of machinery does not work as it was designed to work, we say that it is malfunctioning. It is malfunctioning, not dysfunctioning. As I said, one hears of dysfunctional family, not a malfunctional family. So that's the difference. They both mean the same thing. It's a matter of what is it that you're describing here. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.